Home Assistant is a home automation platform that acts as a central hub for all your smart devices, enabling you to automate a wide range of tasks. For instance, you can set up automations to turn on your lights when you arrive home, or receive notifications when your washing machine finishes a cycle. Home Assistant is the perfect tool for creating all sorts of dashboards and automations for your lights, sensors, speakers, and much more. Home Assistant offers almost 2,500 integrations, making it possible to automate almost anything in your life. By centralizing your smart home into a single platform, you can do away with separate apps for each device and instead create automations between manufacturers. Home Assistant provides endless possibilities for automating your home, making your life easier and more efficient. Best of all, Home Assistant is free and open source, and it runs on hardware that you own, so you won't have to pay subscription fees or sacrifice your privacy. To get started, you'll need a computer or Raspberry Pi that will run Home Assistant. Repurposing an unused desktop or laptop is an excellent option. You can even run it on your personal computer using a virtual machine. To install Home Assistant, you'll need to create a bootable USB drive using Belina Etcher. Begin by visiting homeassistant.io/installation and selecting the generic x86 platform. Then, find the download URL for the boot image and paste it into Etcher. Choose your USB stick and click Flash to start the installation process. Once flashing is complete, plug the Home Assistant USB into your chosen computer and boot from the USB using either the BIOS or boot menu. Once Home Assistant finishes loading, visit the address shown on screen to access the setup wizard. Create your user account and configure your home settings. Then, Home Assistant will prompt you to set up the devices detected on your network. When you see your dashboard, you'll know that Home Assistant is successfully installed, and you can browse between dashboards and pages in the left sidebar. Integrations are the backbone of Home Assistant, and they are available in two flavors, local and cloud-based. Local integrations don't require an internet connection, while cloud integrations do. To get started with integrating your devices into Home Assistant, navigate to Settings and click Devices and Services. Here, you'll find a list of your currently installed integrations, as well as a tab to view all the currently connected devices. To add a new device, return to the Integrations tab, then click Configure on a discovered integration, or select Add and search for the brand of device. Follow the instructions to complete the integration process. Once it is successfully added, new devices and entities will be listed under the integration card. In addition to connecting to Wi-Fi and cloud-based devices, Home Assistant can connect to Zigbee and Z-Wave products. Zigbee and Z-Wave are communication protocols specifically designed for IoT and are often more affordable than Wi-Fi or cloud-based options. These devices don't require an internet connection and communicate with Home Assistant through an additional USB stick, which typically costs around $30. Zigbee and Z-Wave devices come in a wide variety of types, including buttons, lights, outlets, thermometers, as well as water leak, motion, and door sensors. Philips Hue and IKEA are popular companies that use Zigbee in their devices and can be connected to Home Assistant directly through your Zigbee stick, eliminating the need for the manufacturer's hub. It's worth mentioning that a new communication protocol called Thread is on the horizon. Thread-enabled connection sticks that support both Zigbee and Thread are already available, such as SkyConnect by the creators of Home Assistant. Integrations are the backbone of Home Assistant, but it's the automations that bring the platform to life. Automations allow you to trigger actions based on specific events or conditions. To create your first automation, head to Settings and select Automations and Scenes. Click Create to begin. First, choose a trigger for your automation. This could be a device trigger, such as when a light turns on, or a time-based trigger, such as a specific time of day, but just about anything can be a trigger. Next, add the actions you want your automation to perform. For example, you can call a Home Assistant service to control any device in your home. To test specific actions, click the Meatball menu, then select Run. Once you're satisfied with your automation, save it and watch the magic happen.
Don't forget to subscribe.
Check out the Home Assistant forums for automation blueprints that have been designed and tested by the community. These blueprints are often better than creating your own automations from scratch because they save you time and effort while ensuring that the automations are functional and reliable. The Home Assistant mobile app is an essential tool for controlling your smart home on the go. With the app, you can receive notifications, trigger automations, and more, all from the convenience of your mobile device. To make the most of the app, consider enabling zone tracking in the settings. This feature allows you to run automations when you arrive home or to any zone you define in Home Assistant. You can also use NFC tags to trigger automations by tapping your phone in specific locations. This can be a simple and cost-effective way to automate tasks in your home and streamline your daily routine. Home Assistant dashboards provide a comprehensive overview of your smart home. By default, you can access the dashboard by clicking on the Overview tab in the sidebar. If you want to customize your dashboard, simply select Edit in the menu in the top right corner. Dashboards are organized by cards. Add the light card to control your lights. Or the entity card to display device information or state. Additionally, you can add pictures, graphs, weather widgets, and much more to make your dashboard even more informative and personalized. After setting up Home Assistant, you can share it with other users in your household in the settings. You can also configure it for remote access outside of your network using Home Assistant Cloud or port forwarding. In addition to its core functionality, Home Assistant also provides a range of add-ons that can enhance your experience. For example, you can set up file servers, ad blockers, and more to customize your smart home setup even further. So there you have it. Home Assistant is a powerful and versatile tool that can help you build and manage your smart home with ease. From automating simple tasks to complex home automation scenarios, Home Assistant has you covered. Thank you for watching, and if you've enjoyed this content, please consider subscribing for more videos like this.